In this video, we will learn how to create pie points to correspond to the elements in our pie asset framework hierarchy. First, let's go to PySRB1 machine and open Pie System Explorer. To do that, let's go to Start, All Programs, select Pie System, and then select Pie System Explorer. Once the application opens up, let's click on the Database button. Now, let's create a new AF database by clicking on the New Database button. Let's call this as Sample Process-Pumps. Click Enter or say OK. Then highlight the new AF database which we just created and say OK. Now, let's add an element called Sample Process. To do that, right-click on Elements and say New Element. Now say OK. Let's now rename this element as sample process with the capital S for sample. Put a space and say process with the capital P. Now let's define the template for the asset which we are just going to create under sample process. And let's call this as pump. So to do that, click on the Library tab, click on Element Templates, and click on the New Template link. Let's call this as Pump with the capital P and say OK. Now expand Element Templates and click on Pump. Now let's define a few attributes for the pump to correspond to the name on the OPC server. So to see that, let's first minimize this Pie System Explorer. And now let's go to PyInt1 machine. Once we are on PyInt1 machine, from the desktop, right click the OPC client executable and select Run as Administrator. Now let's connect to the node which contains the OPC server, its local host. Click on this button to connect to the node. Double click on the OPC server, which we are interested in, namely opcsample.opcda20server.1. Now let's click on this button to add a group. Accept the defaults and click on create. Now let's browse through the OPC server by clicking on this button. Double click the OPC server and expand the tree. Let's select pump 1, select all, and say add selected. If you click on padding temp, this is the item ID which we are interested in. Kindly note, this should be exactly configured the same way on the instrument tag attribute for the pipe point. This is space sensitive and case sensitive. Now let's say OK. And we can just minimize this and go back to our PySRB1. Once we are on PySRB1 machine, let's get back to Pie System Explorer, which we had minimized earlier. Now let's define a few attributes for the pump. To do that, let's click on the attributes template. Now let's define a few attributes for the pump. To create the first one, we can click on the new attribute template link. Let's define the name for the particular attribute as bearing temp with the capital B, no space, and the word temp with the capital T. From the data reference drop down, select pipe point, and then let's click on settings to define the attributes for the pipe point. Let's set the tag name as percent element percent dot percent attribute percent. Then check the tag creation checkbox and click on this button to define the PyTag attributes. From the dropdown for the point class, let's select classic. And now let's change a few PyPoint attributes, namely instrument tag, location 1, location 4, and point source. First, let's define the instrument tag. So from the drop-down, let's specify a few substitution parameters. Let's select percent dot dot backslash element percent, followed by a forward slash. Let's select another substitution parameter, namely percent element percent. Again, put a forward slash. And lastly, let's define percent attribute percent. Let's select 1 for location 1, which corresponds to interface ID, which we have configured on the Py interface for OPCTA. Location 4, we can choose the second scan class. Point source is OPC, likewise. And if you note the instrument tag substitution parameter, it should result to sample process pump 1 bearing temp, which is the name of the item ID on the OPC server. Let's say OK, and say OK, and check in the changes. And click on check in button here. Let's define a few more set of attributes. So to do that, we can just copy the existing attribute, namely the bearing temp. Right click bearing temp and select copy. Let's paste it once more, and we can rename this particular attribute as flow rate with a capital F and a capital R without any space in between. Flow rate. Now let's define another attribute by right click and say paste. And now once more we can rename this as oil pressure without any space in between with capital O, capital P for pressure. Let's define the next attribute called output flow rate. In a similar fashion, let's say paste and rename this attribute as output with the capital O, without any space, capital F for flow, rate with capital R. Let's define another attribute called pump speed, the same manner, paste, and let's rename this as pump speed without any space in between with the capital P and capital S. Let's define our last attribute for the pump. Let's paste it again and let's rename this as status. This particular status attribute is a digital tag data reference. So let's click on settings to change the tag point type. Let's click on this button. And from the drop down for the point type, let's define this as a digital tag. And it needs to be associated with an appropriate digital set. To do that, we need to create a digital set for the pump. We cannot create digital sets using Py System Explorer. To that, we need to open up Py System Management Tools. To do that, let's go to Start, All Programs, Py System, and let's select Py System Management Tools. Let's go to Points and click on Digital States. Now click on PySRV1, right click and say Add Set. Let's name this as Pump Status with a capital P with no space in between and status with a capital S. Now let's define the digital sets. Let's say 0 means slow. Let's go to the status state name and type in slow. 1 means fast. 2 means A. 3 means nay. Let's save that digital set. Let's minimize by system management tool. And let's define the digital set here. Let's define the substitution parameters. Let's select percent template percent, which is pump, followed by percent attribute percent, which gets the name of the attribute, which is status. And let's say OK. Now let's commit the changes by clicking on check-in. Click check-in button again. Now let's create the pumps for this AF database. So to do that, let's go back to our Elements plugin. Now let's create two pumps using the PySystem Explorer, namely by right-clicking on sample process, and let's create a child element under sample process and select new child element. Now, to create a pump-based asset, let's select the pump template and say OK. Now, let's once more create another asset called pump2 by right-clicking on sample process and selecting new child element. Once again, we chose pump and say OK. Now let's go to the attribute tab. And we would note none of the py tags have been created. So as to create the py tags, click on the sample process, right click and say create or update data reference. By this process, we have created all the tags associated with for all the attributes for pump 1 and pump 2. Let's say OK, close, and we can check into changes. Now, if we click on one of the pumps, we would see the py tags have been created, which says point created. And if our py interface or OPCDA is currently running, in a few minutes time, the values should start updating, for which I can click on the refresh button and see the points updating. Or otherwise, once we start the py interface or OPCDA, the values should start updating. So in this video, we learned how to create py points using the PySystem Explorer.